into the surrounding stone. Another world lay before them, beautiful, but muted, as if something was just beyond view. On the horizon, they caught sight of a sorcerer's tower, one of many ruins that dotted the landscape. This had been a kingdom ruled by magic. A shrine. At the top was a cloak of thick, dark fabric. Flecks of shimmering ore woven into the hem in chain-like patterns. The road fell away to marsh, and the air grew thick. Mushrooms and strange life abounded. Was the mechanism a water gate? An aqueduct, perhaps? Rhyme was puzzled by the idea, though Ember knew of it from her world, where the water flowed free, unchecked. For all the cloak's weight, Rhyme was amazed at how the world changed in Ember's light. Familiar mechanisms lay in the ruins and overgrowth, works of the absent king. He had worked with the sorcerers of this world. Of the other's world for the first time. So unlike their own. The worlds were so different, apart from each other. If the worlds were joined and one touched the other, what would happen? Rhyme thought of life without the crystal beauty of ice. Ember thought of a life devoid of warmth, without autumn's colors. Rivers frozen. Featureless. Still, the world was littered with oceans. Every invention had fallen to time and neglect. The cloak was only one such relic, but it spoke of the ore's tremendous power. The sulfur vents turned the marsh waters unpleasantly hot, and Rhyme found the new sensation troubling. It made him feel as if he were melting. Ember noticed the falling snow whenever she donned the cloak. The slow white rain drifted in the air, reminding her of falling leaves. A great bridge, shattered by an explosion long ago. Experiments with the ore had not always yielded success. Ember began to think of the ice as a slow-moving wave, a ramp ever upwards. Seeing Rhyme encased in it, however, alarmed her, and she feared trapping him within it. Another tower in the midst of fields. A sorcerer's tower. They were surprised the tower had not collapsed, but magic persists. Together, they began to adjust to the temperature changes. Its lows, its heights. Not equilibrium, but close. Mighty bellows had been shaped beneath the mountain. They wondered what other structures lay beneath their feet. A huge stair rose on the far side of the chamber. If bellows were made, that meant a furnace must be fed. All to consume the ore, to shape the artifacts they use now. In this tower, they both felt the tension coiled in the lower platform. When the heat touched it, it would spring upwards sharply. Rhyme flew through the air, feeling the wind on his skin. Heart sank seeing Rhyme imprisoned in the ice. She worked quickly. Every moment he was buried in the ice was too much for her to bear. What happened to the Sorcerer's Kingdom spoke of fire, then flood. In shaping the ore, they brought ruin in their act of creation. Thank you. scarves were all that was left of the absent king in this world. Whatever alliance with the sorcerers had existed, the ore had ended. Ember and Rhyme had seen what had befallen the kingdom, the castle, and wondered if perhaps what happened here was affecting their twin lives as well. Powers of this world made them wonder if the idea of the other's world had shown the reality. If they were to find a way to be together, they would gain much and lose much as well. They felt a strange, familiar vibration, faint at first. There was ore near, somewhere beneath the earth. The cloaks shimmered in the light, the chains on the hem sparkling. The cloak became heavier, as if drinking in the ore's energy. They came upon what seemed a great windmill, tilting platforms designed to turn in the wind, or the heat and cold. Hot springs boiled up from the depths of the marsh, creating fissures in the road above. The faint smell of sulfur lingered in the air. Ember was grateful she could still breathe in the cloak's embrace, as could Ryan, even trapped in ice. Despite their differences, at least the air and water were not against them. A dam had been built here, but time had been the water's ally. The locks of the dam were cracked and splintered, the water now flowing freely through the cracks. Thank you. The submerged chambers took on an odd light in the heat from the vents. So much of this world lay beneath the water. Yet the sorcerer's ambitions for the ore seemed to account for much of the ruin, not the marsh. The towers grew larger, grander, and the destruction that had been brought to them more savage. Ember was briefly grateful that Rhyme's ice preserved this world and its ruins against the elements, even if only for a short time. The world below was almost as great as the kingdom above. Two kingdoms of sky and water meeting. Ember noticed the black scarf cast no reflection on the ice's surface, and she shivered. On both the battlements and the rises in the road where only the rains could touch, time made its presence felt. Everything was a marker of the past, not whatever future they had envisioned. The sorcerer's experiments with the ore had left their mark. Entire structures had caved in, insides exposed to the wind and the water. From below the water, There was a rumble of wood against stone, and the surface of the false lake rippled. Platforms shifted beneath the water, like stairs. The road neared a familiar door, and a familiar presence. The dragon was hidden, and wished to conceal itself from men. All that was needed was to expose it to the light. Cloak had allowed each to experience the world of the other, and they were stronger for it.